do you guys realize that the Dow has soared over 1,000 points since the riots? So this just in, breaking news that riots are actually good for the stock market? No, it really doesn't even matter. So in this video, I'm also gonna show you the difference between the financial economy and the real economy and all this new stuff that you guys hear, like, oh, we got this happening, we got that happening. I'm gonna go back in time and we are going to look at what happened when a sitting US president was assassinated. Did the market go up? Did it go down? Did it stay the same? Is it a good time to get in? Good time to get out? And April factory orders crash by the most in American history. And what kind of recovery are we gonna have in the economy? The real economy, not the financial economy. And I'm gonna show you it's more like, instead of a W or an L, it's more like a Nike swoosh. And the next wave of job cuts isn't what we just had. We had the lower end. Now we're actually targeting the higher end, and these are job cuts in the millions. So for those of you making the big cheddar, be on the lookout. And holy hell, low kitty, remember? I recommended Sava, and you guys were like leaving comments in the comment section yesterday saying, oh my gosh, do you see what is happening with Sava? So we will go into that trade, take a look at it, see how much even my son-in-law is like, oh, I made money. I'm like, yes, that is why I came up with this channel, to help you guys make more money. And I'm gonna tell you what the number one comment was, because I asked you, can you help me with, what do I need to say? You know, welcome back to my channel. What is it? Because you guys know more than what actually I know. And according to Bruno, which I pinned at the end, because I'm like, I need it at the top, so when I scroll, I can just show you guys. Welcome to my channel, where I have better hair than your girlfriend. And that comment got exactly 69 likes, and no one even threatens to change that number. You're like, I really want to like this comment, but nah. Welcome back to my channel. Where I have better hair than your girlfriend. But if you like a channel that actually can help you, or at least I try, cover all the news, cover all the stuff, all the stoof, trying to help you guys make more money, would you just at least consider hitting that subscribe button? It feels good. I actually like talking to people. So, you know, if you're down for that, welcome aboard. So this chart coming in from Zero Hedge, I mean, I was kind of too lazy just to go over to my trading view, but here you go. I like the green. We are up over 1,000 points. And what's the we have all this bad news. What seems to be happening? Why is there such a disconnect? Well, like I've said for the last, I don't, ever since. Now this is what I wanted to talk to you guys about. Worst social unrest in forever, right? Decades. Terrible. It's all horribly bad. Globally, nothing is working. When it comes to the, you know, the vaccine. Sorry, I have to watch my words. The vaccine, there really isn't any. And our earnings are in the toilet. GDP, you just flush those right down. And to show you the disconnect of, and I got this from one of my subscribers. He's like, hey, look this one up. John F. Kennedy assassinated November 22nd, 1963. Did the market go up? Did it go down? What happened? And I'm gonna pull up a chart during that time, and you're gonna look at it and go like, oh, I think it probably happened right here. This is where I think it all went down and the markets took a hit. But the truth is, now we're just working on the monthly, it was right there. That was it. And actually, if I were to do the daily, which I'm gonna try, and here it is, November 22nd, 1963. Candle close came, went right down to the 200. That would be the black line, bounced right off of it, close to it. And then the next few days, it actually closed above. I think the day of and the day after was down a couple percent. But as you guys can see from the chart, complete separation from the stock market and the news. And since I have TradingView up, let's take a look at Sava. And before I do that, I just want to say, for those of you that try to trade Bitcoin, just know Bitcoin is one of the hardest things to ever, I have ever had to trade in my entire life. Trading equities is way easier, and all the technicals that I have ever thrown at Bitcoin, I'm like, Well, it looked like a bull flag. So for those of you that have come over from cryptocurrencies and you're like, oh, okay, well, maybe I'll give equities a try, way easier. And here's Sava. I'll click on the full featured chart in a second, but you can kind of already see, like, we had some movement there. And it's so cool when you do videos. And this actually, I did not get Sava from my brain. I was like, I didn't have any, you know, picker. This was actually done through ZipTrader. And I've mentioned that many of times on swing trading, because all you dudes are out there like scouring stocks. And you're like, hey, how about this one? Then everyone piles into it. And this one had a beat down. But if you have stop losses, and I need to say this is not financial advice, can never be. I'm a complete idiot. I'm just a YouTuber. Don't ever listen to anything that I say. You'll lose all of your money plus more. So just click away, throw your laptop out the window after it lands on the grass, go smash it, take it into the pool, swim to the bottom of the pool with it. And then when you're done with that, put it into the microwave, settings 10 minutes if it does not fit in the microwave, buy a bigger microwave. Whew, was that enough to make sure that you click the, there it is. God, I hate having to click that thing so many times. All right, it comes up, here's your swing trades. And you guys could, you know, this gets kind of junky, you know, where you're in, out, but then this was a clear one and you're like, oh, and then there's your candle right there. You want one candle close above the 20. It depends on how you set all these things up. You can go, you know, what kind of moving averages, but just stick to what you use and don't go, well, okay, now I'll trade on the 4 hour, 1 hour, 1 minute. It changes if you start changing your stuff. But if you stay consistent, you will have consistent not returns. And here is Sava falling from its graces, right? And even on this one, you wouldn't have got caught. You wouldn't have put in a buy on that. And then it just falls down like a beaten dog down here. And then you grab the one swing. And on this one, and you could take profits, you know, whenever, and you could actually grab it when, you know, whenever you want there. I don't know how you guys are trading, but this is a 64.7, 65% return on your moolah. And my son-in-law closed his position. I think it was right when he saw the light bar. He's like, yeah, okay, I'm out. But you could actually wait, you know, you could come into a position on the MACD. See that, that little spot right there. I think if I follow that one up, and then you close your position, see when these two lines and they go, oh, and then they start to diverge like that. And then you can close your position on that. So there was Sava, 65%, not too bad. And if this is the very first time that you're like, wait, this, why does this look so easy? It's not easy, okay? You're gonna fail a lot. Just know. You want to paper trade, kind of figure it out. And for me, whether I'm paper trading or it's actual, you still get the same, like, yes, I did it. Even though if it's real digits, fake digits, you still get that same dopamine response where you're like, I actually know something. But if you want to really learn and grab a course on it, ZipTrader, not me. I do not currently have a course on trading equities. Link in the description. Charlie gives you guys 10% off, and I would highly recommend it. And also, if you've been on this channel long enough, you know I'm not like everyone else. I'm not a buy and holder. I'm not a, ooh, dividends, dividend investing. Because when this market turns, I want to have a stop loss. I want to be out. Kind of like on Bitcoin. When I'm like, I had my stop at 8,300. It was 100%. I was completely out. I was out. The only thing that I buy and hold in my life would be Lamborghinis. Because they always hold their resale value. You know, you put down a $500,000 and booyah, the next time you look, it's worth like, what, $90,000? I do hold rental properties. And I don't flip those. So real estate, too messy. I like just buying and holding. And then gold. I just look at gold as just money. It just sits there. Looks pretty. Kind of keeps everything the same. Just sit there. Look pretty. Beat inflation. And we can always remain friends. But now we need to head over to Advisor Perspectives. And look at this story, a pretty recent, 6-1 market cap to GDP, an update look at Buffett valuation indicator. And this is the bad news. So I give you the good news, I give you the bad news. Now, if I was a buy and holder, I'd be freaking out. If I was a hedge fund manager and I, you know, like for me, it's like little, it's like click, click. But these people have like billions of dollars underneath them. And you got to move that. You got to think like way ahead. Are we in quad one? Are we in quad two? Are we in quad three, four? Inflation, deflation? Do I see stagflation? Nope. I just swing, take the beans right off the table and call it a day. And by looking at this chart, super overvalued. And where do we get it from? GDP, the gross domestic product. And that's basically everything that we are as the United States, all of our sales, it's everything. You as a consumer, you go out there and spend. I think that's about 70 to 75% of GDP. It's all the kit, all the caboodle. And looking at these charts, pretty frightening. We are in, I mean, if you look at year 2000, we're at like 2000 levels. And if you want to like do nominal, here's nominal quarterly GDP. We're even above year 2000 levels. So 2020, I mean, there is no stopping this train of overvaluations. And being a macro guy, I think, you know, all laws of nature, when you have like gravity, but even with that being said, these things can be very irrational for longer than you can remain solvent. So please be very careful. A lot of my very smart friends have been betting against this market for a very long time, and they're losing truckloads of money. I don't know. That is just not for me. I don't want to try to really look ahead and go, okay, this is where I definitely believe. Because I'm wrong more times than I am right. And here's U.S. manufacturers. The order's just completely, again, it's like story after story falling off the cliff. And this was April, and you could go back, you know, to time in the beginning and still not be able to find a drop like this ever. So March down 10, April down roughly 13. And then this is our U.S. factory orders month over month. Again, unprecedented. And this coming in from Real Investment Advice, since I can't give you any, why the recovery will fall short of forecast. All right, my macro guys, let's scroll on down. Will the economy recover as a V, U, or L-shaped fashion? And if we get to the end, they're actually going to say it's more like a Nike swoosh. And you have GDP, which I just talked to you about, and 74%. What'd I say? Between 70 and 75? That is you, consumer spending. 74% of GDP since 1948. It has averaged 65%. And then I'm sure I'll get trolled somewhere in the comment section being like, oh, it's 65%. You don't know what the frack you're even talking about. Personal consumption drives GDP. And as you can see, there has been no personal consumption because you guys are all just stuck in your house. Here's PCE and payrolls. Also, right down into the toilet, which what I think I could do, I'm going to draw a toilet bowl. And as we scroll down, I have a feeling all these little indicators over up there in that area when my finger disappears. Sorry, backwards camera, I don't know where I'm at. One moment. So here is my nice toilet bowl. Perfect drawings, Johnny Bravo. Very good. If you're wondering why it is a red, I started with red and I got too lazy. So we just we'll just kind of keep it that way. And as you can see, the toilet seat is left in the upwards direction. It's just kind of sitting there. Remember, gentlemen, do not put up or down the toilet seats because you get yelled at. Make sure you have your simp card on you at all times. This has actually been an ongoing fight in this family for the last 50 years with six daughters. They're like, Dad! Or my wife's like, you left the toilet seat up. I'm like, yeah, you want me to put it down and pee on it? They're like, but I fell in the toilet last night. Well, I'm like, guess you probably should have just checked to see, you know, if I did or didn't. But for the sake of argument, forever, I will just leave it down and I will pee all over it. So let me see. Let's move up and see if my toilet bowl works. Yep, there it goes. There's personal consumption right in the hooper. Moving on down. Let's see what else is going in there. Oh, we'll throw that in there. Payrolls, going right in the toilet. There you go. Anything else? Corporate debt, putting two and two together. Oh, what's going into it is the forecast. All right. I got to kind of move it. I'd have to move it over a little bit. And what this is basically saying is that jobs will recover at a rate like 2008, and then looking at this, you have PCE, and then you have the forecast, which just barely nicks the toilet. This is what happens, right? Just nicks it, goes up, hits the toilet seat, and then back into the toilet. But basically, if again, I have to summarize and tell you what this means. We're not going back to normal until 2020. 25, and then, you know, perfect fit right there. There is your swoosh. The recovery we laid out above is not a V or a U. It is basically a Nike swoosh logo with a sharp decline and a long period of recovery. And then this, just in, next wave of U.S. job cuts, I said, it's going to target millions of higher paid workers. Oh, no. And it even gives you an angle here. If you don't know how to hit the right area, it's right about there. And Bloomberg actually does a really good job at this. Very, very nice. So first wave, and then you got second wave. First wave, you know, restaurants just got wiped out. Social assistance, general merchandise stores. Yeah, that didn't work out too well. Clothing and accessories. Well, unless you own an Amazon store, which I keep a preaching, that's not going away. Brick and mortar, bye. And who wants to pay all of that? When I own brick and mortar, what a nightmare with 35 employees, you know, doing hair and massage and, you know, estheticians and nails and all that kind of stuff. No, thank you. I would rather sell nail polish online any day. But if you would like to learn how to start an online business, I leave a link in the description for somewhere around 90% off, maybe 93. I haven't done the math. Two courses, selling on Amazon. And if you're an action taker, which I am, I don't care. I'll launch it and go like, all right, I'll learn better next time. Consider just maybe taking a look at it. It's $195 rather than $1,300. Why, Johnny Bravo, do you make such it hard to get? And well, because there's only a few codes and they go pretty darn fast. I need to always apologize for that. I got to apologize for everything. But I need to help you guys out. My phone is just bzz, 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 and I'm just like voice speaking. And for those of you that reach out to me and you're like, what the heck is this sentence? Is he drunk? No, I have to voice speak. But back to the pretty colors on the left side. You got the pink, the first wave. That's where my daughter, she's a flight attendant, air travel wiped out. Kid hasn't worked in a while. Second wave. Oh, let's see. Where's me? Oh, education right there. That would be me. The second wave where they're like, sorry, Johnny Bravo. We got to cut salary. You know, you teachers making way too much. Actually, I think I do. But I have a master's degree. I've been teaching for over 20 something years. And if they let me go, I'm like, oh, wow. Okay. What am I going to do? Maybe I'll figure something out. Maybe I'll start a business on YouTube or Amazon and sell something. I do practice what I preach. But if you are in any of these, you know, if any of these look like maybe you in, you know, wave two, you may want to consider, actually, this is Amazon colors too. Just might want to think about it. Or you could start a YouTube channel. Get some little ad money coming into your pocket. You just have to sit there and basically get roasted on the daily. But I do have to say I'm open to getting roasted on. I'm okay in the comments section. So if you guys ever want to let me have it, you just let me have it. I am a humble dude. I will take your criticism and go like, huh, okay, if I have audio issues or lighting issues, I'll look at that and go, okay, thank you. Or if you just want to say, you know what, I came on for 5 seconds, I looked at your face and I just had no other choice but to click away. But for real, guys, I love you. You're amazing. The comments, and I don't have time. If you want, maybe I could do this. I have enough time because I think my last video, what was there, like 500 comments? Imagine that. Your girlfriend or your wife texts you about the girlfriend that she just found out that, yeah, and you're sitting there on your, and you have to respond to 500. It's hard. What I can do though is just like put the little heart, you know, on each one of them, like as I'm reading, like, oh, that's funny. Ah, that's funny. But like, wow, I could usually only respond in the comment section for the first maybe like 20 minutes. And my wife's like, are you coming down for dinner? It's so sad. The rich are losing their jobs. The poor are losing their jobs. The rich get richer. The poor get poorer. The middle class is getting wiped out too. The system that was created is a debt-based Keynesian system. It just over time, it wipes everyone out. And as you can see right here, here's the top 1%. They own, do you see, they keep gobbling it up until they basically own everything. And it really, I mean, if I can kind of go back on this chart, when we were taking off the gold standard of 71, it didn't look like this. But more important is this bottom 50%, which, you know, most people live in, 50% of us in the United States of America, is right here. Look at that. Right next to my arm. Right here. Nothing. You guys own no wealth. Nothing at all. You enter this world with nothing, and I guess you leave with nothing. I mean, do you think maybe you want to risk something and take a shot at that area? Maybe leave a legacy? Something? Take a risk? You only live, what, three times? I listened to Johnny Bravo and I just went all in. I'm not saying that. No, you go in, like, carefully, pieces. But you're starting businesses, you're trading equities, you're copying these guys right here. The rich people, copy what they do and stop coming down here and watching these people. Don't copy these people. I mean, you can hang out with them, have fun, but if you want to be able to buy a fishing pole and go fishing for your entire life, you got a few years to figure that out. So hopefully this video provided you some valuable information. You got into my little noggin. And if you did, can you just do something, you know, maybe like it, subscribe, just something, just a little click to help me out, and I will see you tomorrow.